JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for August the 27th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all the other G10 currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian morning Thursday. It underperformed the most versus Kiwi, NOK, Aussie and the pound in that order, while it lost the least ground against the euro and the Swiss franc. Now, the weakness of the dollar and the Swiss franc combined with the strength in the risk-linked Kiwi suggests that market participants may have increased their risk exposure yesterday. Indeed, looking at the equity world, we see that major EU and US indices were a sea of green, but during the Asian session today, participants' appetite softened again. It seems that the catalyst behind the boost during the EU session may have been the accord among Germany's coalition parties with regards to extending the measures aimed at cushioning the economic effects from the pandemic. France is also set to present an economic recovery plan on September 3rd. The optimism rolled over into the US session, with the S&P 500 and Nasdaq hitting fresh record highs, as investors stayed focused on tech-related stocks that have outperformed since the onset of the crisis. That said, things changed during the Asian trading today, with participants scaling down their risk exposure, perhaps due to fresh tensions between the US and China. Yesterday, the US blacklisted 24 Chinese firms and targeted individuals, saying that they were part of military action in the South China Sea, while China, in a warning to the US, launched two missiles into the sea. As for today, we stick to our guns that the spotlight is likely to fall on the Jackson Hole Annual Economic Symposium, which will be held virtually this time, and especially on Fed Chair Powell's keynote speech scheduled for today. Last week, the minutes of the latest FOMC gathering revealed that several officials suggested that additional accommodation could be required and added that fiscal support would also be necessary. However, they saw only modest benefits from adopting a yield curve control strategy, and thus this was not warranted for now. Now, with no clear picture as to what form any potential additional easing may take, investors may lock their gaze on Powell's speech for more clarity on that front. They may also be looking for clues on the timing of any additional action, especially if the White House and Congress Democrats stay deadlocked in agreeing over a new coronavirus aid package. If the Fed chief suggests that further stimulus is on the cards, perhaps as early as next month, equities are likely to extend their uptrends while the dollar is likely to continue tumbling. The opposite may be true if Powell appears less dovish than anticipated, something that could scale back expectations over fresh accommodative measures before the end of this year. Market chatter also suggests that Powell may address a future approach to the inflation target, allowing consumer prices to move higher and thereby delay any potential increase in interest rates. Something like that could add further pressure on the dollar, while it could prove positive for equities as it would mean extra loose monetary policy for longer. Now, as for the rest of today's events, the second estimate of the US GDP for the second quarter, initial jobless claims for last week, and pending home sales for July are on the schedule. The second estimate of the US GDP is forecast to show a modest upside revision to -32.5 from -32.9, while initial claims are forecast to have declined to 1 million from 1.106 million, the week before. Pending home sales are expected to have slowed to 3% month over month from 16.6% in June. As for tonight, during the Asian morning Friday, Japan's Tokyo CPIs for August are due out. No forecast is available for the headline rate, while the core one is anticipated to have ticked down to 0.3% year over year from 0.4%. Now, besides Fed Chair Powell, we have two more speakers on today's agenda. Bank of Canada Governor Tiff Macklem and ECB Executive Board Member Philip Lane. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.